بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. We are still talking about the hadith narrated by Imam al-Tirmidhi, in which the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم is reported to have said, اتق الله حيثما كنت واتبع السيئة الحسنة تمحوها وخالق الناس بخلق حسن. We talked about the first part of this hadith, which mainly talks about the taqwa. And then we moved on to talk about the second part of the hadith, which talks about, you know, the fact that once the person have done a kind of a mistake, kind of a sin, and he wants to get it forgiven by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he can just easily get it forgiven by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, saying astaghfirullah al-azim. And we quoted this hadith of Sayyidina Mu'adh ibn Jabal radiallahu anhu, when he heard the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as saying, whoever has committed a sin and he wants to get it forgiven, he should follow it immediately with something good, with hasana. And Sayyidina Mu'adh asked, Ya Rasulullah, Ala ilaha illallah hasana? And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, this is the best of hasanat, this is the best of things that you can say in order to get your sin forgiven by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we said that this is mainly for the minor sins, because as we said, sins are divided into two categories. The first category is the minor sin, and the second category is the major sin, as Dr. Hussain again was talking about these points yesterday. And we said that minor sins are just forgiven by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala easily if the person remembers Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and he says astaghfirullah, he says la ilaha illallah, and he is trying his best as much as he can to avoid the major sins. الَّذِينَ يَجْتَنِبُونَ كَبَائِرَ الْإِثْمِ وَالْفَوَاحِشَ إِلَّا اللَّمَمَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when talking about the characteristics or the attributes of the righteous people, he said subhanahu wa ta'ala, those people for whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is preparing paradise, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is forgiving their sin, are those kinds of people who are avoiding the major sins. And we said for the major sin, the person needs only to repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with the condition. The first condition is that he should feel sorry and remorse for whatever kind of sin he had committed. And then he needs to have a strong commitment that he is not going to do it again. And then if the sin is related to somebody, as for example, if somebody, you know, has, you know, taken the money from someone, for example, and he wants to repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it is not logic, it is not, you know, of use if he would say, Ya Allah, I'm sorry and I want to get my sin forgiven, why he is still having the money of this person? He needs first to go back to the person and give him the money back, and then ask him to forgive him, and then he should repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then, it should be before the last stage of this, as we gave the example of Fir'aun, when he was dying, you know, and he was saying, قَالَ آمَنْتُ أَنَّهُ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا الَّذِي آمَنَتْ بِهِ بَنِي إِسْرَائِيلَ وَأَنَا مِنَ الْمُسْلِمِينَ. And he said he was just repenting to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He was believing in the same Lord of Bani Israel, and he was from amongst the Muslims, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was ironically asking him, الآن وقد عصيت قبل وكنت من المفسدين. Now, are you repenting now while you didn't have the chance, your lifetime to repent, and you didn't, and you were from among those who were corrupting on earth? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not accept the repentance from him. So this is just in brief the summary of what we have said. You know, the question is, how would I know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had accepted my tawbah? This is a good question. You know, okay, we are repenting and we are coming back to the sin again. We might be committing the same thing that we have, you know, repented to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So still, we are human beings. We are, you know, we have been created by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to err. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants us all the time to repent to Him. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants us all the time to come back to Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is very much explained by the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala feels so happy of the repentance of one of you. As you know, can you imagine somebody who is just going in the desert and he has nothing except the camel or whatever, you know, a horse or whatever an animal he has,
And he has all kinds of things on this camel, on this animal. He has food, he has water, he has, you know, a means of safety. And all of a sudden he lost to this camel in the desert. And according to the explanation of the Prophet ﷺ, he said, such a person is just waiting. You know, he just found that tree over there and he just said, underneath this tree, he was just waiting for death to come to him. And everything is just finished. He has nothing to survive with. And he was just waiting for death to come to him. And all of a sudden, he, you know, found the camel just in front of him. And he's just taking it. Can you imagine how joyful, how happy this person is going to be? The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is feeling more happy, you know, with the repentance of his servant, than this person having or finding back the camel that he had lost. So this is how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala feels about the person who is repenting to him. Because, you know, once the person repents to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, means that, Ya Allah, I am sorry, I have committed something that you didn't like, that is displeasing you. And now, I am completely aware that it's you who is gonna accept my tawbah, who's gonna, you know, forgive my sin. So again, the question is, how would I know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepted my tawbah? Because we might have committed so many mistakes, and you know, we have repented to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we might have come again to committing the same mistake. According to Muslim scholars, they said that the fact that the person is repenting to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the fact that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guides the person to make tawbah, this is in itself a dalil, a criteria that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepts the tawbah from him. Because we have so many millions of Muslims worldwide, and not all of them are making tawbah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, right? So the fact that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala helps you or guides you to make the tawbah itself, this is in itself a dalil, a criteria, or a means to know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepts your tawbah. And this is mentioned in the Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when talking about some people, he said, ثُمَّ تَابَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِمْ لِيَتُوبُوا. So it is not you who is making tawbah. It's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who is guiding you to make tawbah. Why? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants you to get your sin forgiven by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the fact that you are making tawbah, this is in itself a criteria that your tawbah is accepted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is again what was understood by Sayyidina Umar ibn Khattab when he was talking about dua. Some people might say, Ya Allah, we are all the time making dua, but you never accept my dua. Astaghfirullah al-Azim. We can never say that. Because the fact that again, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala helps you or guides you to make dua, this is in itself a dalil that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is accepting your dua. But in different ways. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala might, you know, may answer your dua immediately. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala may postpone answering your dua till the new judgment, when everybody will be wishing if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would have postponed answering all his dua till the new judgment because of all the blessings that he's gonna get on the new judgment. The third way of accepting your dua is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala might have, you know, decreed that a certain kind of serious problem is gonna come to you. And by your dua, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had lifted this kind of problem with the knowledge, with the ultimate knowledge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is according to the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in which he says, the dua and the bala are yata'arakan or yatanaharan. The dua is just getting up and the bala is just getting down. And they are meeting in between. And the stronger is going to beat the other. If your dua is stronger, it's going to take away the severe or serious testing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had decreed for you. But if your dua is weak, the testing is going to come to you on this dua. So the dua is definitely answered. And this is the promise of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَقَالَ رَبُّكُمُ دُعُونِي أَسْتَجِبْ. This is the promise from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah just said, ادعوني. Just make dua to me. That's it. This is your part. And Allah's part is that I'm going to answer your dua. وَقَالَ رَبُّكُمُ دُعُونِي أَسْتَجِبْ لَكُمْ. And in the ayah that we have heard very frequently these days, because it's coming in between the ayahs of Siyam, وَإِذَا سَأَلَكَ عِبَادِي عَنِّي فَإِنِّي قَرِيبٌ What? أُجِيبُ دَعْوَةَ الدَّاعِي إِذَا دَعَان إِذَا دَعَان يعني Allah SWT is saying يعني يا محمد if they would ask you about me, I am always there. I am answering the dua of the person who is making dua in case he makes the dua. But if he cannot make dua, if he does not make dua, خلاص. خلاص. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying again, وَإِذَا سَأَلَكَ عِبَادِي عَنِّي فَإِنِّي قَرِيبٌ And coming back to Sayyidina Umar ibn Khattab, he said, إِنِّي لَا أَحْمِلُ هَمَّ الْإِجَابَةِ وَلَكِنِّي أَحْمِلُ هَمَّ الدُّعَاءِ Sayyidina Umar ibn Khattab said, I am not worried about getting my dua answered by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Why? Because it's Allah who had promised it in the Quran. But I am worried about me making the dua. So the fact that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guides you or makes you to make dua, this is again in itself a criteria or you know a dalil or a proof that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is accepting your dua. And this is the month of dua, and we should all the time make use of our time to make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So again, the major sins are to be forgiven only by the tawbah with the conditions that we mentioned. And if you feel that the person upon whom I have made something wrong, and once I am confronting him and telling him, Ya Akhi, I have done such and such things to you, and if I feel that he is going to be overreacting, and he might be, you know, doing something more serious than what I have committed, in such a case, Muslim scholars are saying that, use your own judgment. And you do not need to tell him in such a case. But you can just ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive yourself, and to forgive him as well. So just make a compensation. If you cannot just go ahead and talk to him because of your expectation of the overreacting that he may, you know, be behaving, in such a case, just make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive you and to forgive him as well. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to shower us with his blessings, to accept our fasting, to accept our prayer, to accept our dua. Allahumma ja'al jam'ana haza jam'an marhuma, wa ja'al tafarruqana min ba'dihi tafarruqan ma'suma. Allahumma la taj'al fina wa la baynana wa la minna shakiyan wa la mahruma. Allahumma taqabbal siyamana wa salatana wa ruku'ana wa sujudana ya rabbal alameen. Allahumma taqabbal du'ana ya rabbal alameen. اللهم إنا نسألك أن تجعل أول يومنا هذا صلاحا وأوسطه فلاحا وآخره نجاحا اللهم إنا نسألك ألا تدع لنا في هذا اليوم ذنبا إلا غفرته ولا هما إلا فرجته ولا دينا إلا قضيته ولا مريضا إلا شفيته ولا ميتا إلا رحمته ولا ميتا إلا رحمته ولا ضالا إلا هديته ولا عدوا إلا قصمته ولا طالب علم إلا وفقته ولا مسافرا في برك وبحرك وجوك إلا إلى آله سالما رددته وصل اللهم وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا وجزاكم الله خيرا.